Leslie David Baker, played Stanley on The Office. You're listening to your nerd side.
Hi, this is Shannon Farnan, and you are listening to your nerd side.
Well, welcome to this week's show of your nerd side. And if you ever want to reach out to the show to see what's up or ask questions, curious about stuff, it's always at your nerd side on social media. Okay, on the show, we're going to be talking about SpaceX because I am a nerd and I love the big launch. And then we're going to be talking about a new TV show and some other stuff happening and some cool stuff I found in the media. And then we are going to be talking to two actresses. I got to say it right.
Actors.
I got to always do it. Mark Ralston's going to be joining us. And another lady by Jenette Goldstein. She was from Aliens. They were together at the same table. So I interviewed them at the same time. We'll get into that. AMV's joining me too.
Hi there.
We're going to come right back and we're going to start the show. And I'm going to get nerdy about space travel.
Welcome to Comic-Con.
Where once a year, sci-fi buffs take their lips off the barrel of a loaded gun and spend half a day adjusting their eyes to sunlight.
You want to see a comic book with pregnant zombie nuns?
You psychotic nerd!
Dude, what a bunch of freaking nerdos!
Get to see him white and nerdy. Little B, I'm white and nerdy.
I'm a nerd too.
Your personality needs some work.
You're not part of the popular clique.
But I was kind of a lonely nerd in high school.
I started a quilt. I did yoga twice a week. I wore flip-flops in public.
I like to roll with the gangsters. It's apparent I'm too white and nerdy.
I'm just too white and nerdy.
I'm just too white and nerdy.
Look at me, I'm white and nerdy.
Well, SpaceX launched, if you saw any of it, I was so stoked about it. The first time in 9 years, the first time out of U.S. soil, we actually took off with a rocket ship, but I just wasn't excited about it. I was fanatically...
You were not?
No, I'm going even deeper than that. I wasn't excited about it. I was a fanatic about it. Yeah. It was amazing. This is space... This is actual stuff where we're going to go to the next boundary, and we're going to turn into Star Trek. And we're going to boldly go where no man has gone before. Because the way the ship went, it was amazing. Musk, you know him better than me.
He was born in South Africa.
What an amazing, crazy guy. I mean, the stuff he comes up with, but kind of goofy.
Wait, what was the name that he was going to name his kid a name and then put it out there. Mm. And now he's changing his child's name.
To what?
I could look that up. I mean, it's not. I think we have our own issues with our own child's son's name.
Okay, so this is the thing that's cool. So if you watch the launch, SpaceX, the cool thing was, yes, the spacesuits, they were so cool. And if you thought they were really, 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 really good, they were built for designed by a producer. They look like they came off a movie. The suits were designed by legendary Hollywood costume designer Jose Fernandez, who's known for costumes in blockbusters such as Wonder Woman, Wolverine, Batman vs. Superman, and Captain America Civil War. So that's why Elon wanted the most greatest suit ever designed. He said he needed a tuxedo of spacesuits. But even besides that, the suits are so cool. They're sleeker, not as bulky. They allow you to go out into space. They keep track of you in the side there. And they test flight the SpaceX crew, the Dragon, suits and other launches on test. And these are supposed to be the most up-to-date suits ever. Keeping track of your body temperature and everything else. So all that stuff we see in movies with the cameras inside the helmet, they said that is in there, but we're not seeing it. That's just for the crew. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Now, let's see how much you are of a nerd on the SpaceX. Okay. So, every outfit is amazing based on comfort and efficiency.
Yeah.
So, how do they go to the bathroom in those SpaceX costumes?
There's a little thing in there they pee inside of.
Really? Okay, because per Business Insider, the toilet in the Dragon capsule is on the ceiling.
Good for them.
So
when they get in trouble, shit really does hit the fan, but it hits the roof.
Well, it does something, and it better do something great, because that Crew Dragon was built with $3.14 billion of our tax dollars.
So our tax dollars? I thought Elon put some money into it.
Oh, my friend. That's what people think.
Well, even if he didn't, the thing he designed and he did on his own was, and the most amazing thing about it, and most people don't realize this, is it was the average rocket that went up in space. Not a space shuttle, because a space shuttle isn't that great of a spaceship. It can't be, it can't go farther than what it can do. It just orbits and comes back. That's it.
But I have a question for our audience, because you don't...
See, I couldn't finish my story, but that's
okay,
fine.
Okay, go ahead, beautiful. All right, you're too gorgeous. That's why I interrupt. Sorry.
So the rocket ship goes up, right? And when it releases the second part, like all the other ones, and they usually just dropped it or float out in space and left it, it came down and landed on a dock in the ocean and came back. They already have it back. So it landed on its own 2 feet. This is the most biggest breakthrough ever. Now they're getting it ready because August, they're going back in space. She has something to say. What's up?
Oh, no, I'm just stretching, but I agree of all your enthusiasm. I just think there should be caution out there. So let's see how great our audience and Fonseca is. So who remembers the movie Contact by Jodie Foster in 1997? Actually, got good reviews.
Include the movie that's not real? Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, I remember it. So in that movie, yes, the U.S. had some problems with their own technology.
Mm-hmm.
And they used private money. And you have to assume that forever and ever, people who use their private money will be using this for good causes. So we got to be kind of knowledgeable and careful. You should know this. There was actually a hint of that in Space Force, a Netflix movie, which has a lot of irony with the timing of it, with some leaders have used that language before, where there was a goodwill mission about checking out the temperature in the moon.
Yeah.
And one certain country was doing some naughty things on
there. Are you talking about China?
I'm trying to be diplomatic.
We'll get into that. You know what? Let's not talk about the Steve Carell show. Let's live in the happier moment right now and not go in that direction.
Woo! Let's talk about SpaceX.
All right. Finishing up with SpaceX, I personally think, and myself, from seeing stuff when I was a kid, the space shuttle, bad stuff happening in 86 and all that good stuff.
You want to tell that for our younger audience what happened there?
1986, space shuttle went up into outer space, and it exploded.
And it was the first time they had a civilian who was a teacher, and we all watched it live as eighth graders.
So SpaceX, congratulations. I thought it was amazing. I love the spacesuits. I love the way it landed down. It was pretty great.
And I want to tell
the
Elon...
The original... Go ahead. You can talk. What do you want to tell Elon?
I'm sorry. I want to just tell Elon's son, I wish him the best with his name, because legal name they were trying to do, but it's illegal in California, is... XAEA-X, lowercase I.
That's the name I want.
But it's interesting because his twins are Griffin, Xavier, and triplets Damien, Saxon, and Kay.
I'm this artist formerly known as Fonseca. I just go by as an X. So originally the SpaceX was supposed to take off into outer space, and it got scrubbed. And Kelly Clarkson performs the national anthem before NASA's attempted space launch. Kelly sang before... The launch and the crew and stuff. I want you to hear how she sounded. Tell me how this sounds.
Say, can you see?
Have they ever done this before? Before a space launching national anthem?
They should.
So instead of saying play ball, do they go launch? And it takes off?
I've rarely seen this, but I'm not surprised that somebody was putting on a show. We do have a leader that is a reality star.
All right, Kelly Clarkson, I'm done with you. So a lead into this is, and it's kind of amazing, not only did we have the launch of SpaceX, but a TV show that I binge-watched in one day with my little son, and it was so good. Steve Carell was back from The Office, and it was called Space Force. And let me tell you something. If President Trump was about to launch a space program, this would be the space program that he would do. It was freaking hilarious.
Now, can you tell our audience why it's hilarious? Because for some reason, Rotten Tomatoes gave it an average of 39% from their professionals. But audience gave it a 75, which I think the 75 is even low. So tell us why.
Because it was funny. It was hilarious. Everything about politics and everything you think of that could possibly happen to something in a space program happened on the show. I'm telling you, it was just so good. We're going to hear from Steve Carell himself. Steve Carell told us exactly how he got the idea to do Space Force.
Well, it's almost like parallel development, too, because they released the pictures of their new uniforms, and then we released the pictures of our new uniforms, and they released they unfurled their flag in the White House recently, and it's so funny how certain aspects mirror each other and how, you know, there's differentiation for sure. And incidentally, the people who are in charge of Space Force have been really really nice about it, have had a great sense of humor about our show, haven't been thin-skinned at all, and so they seem to be fans so far, which is nice.
So, and you gotta admit, I mean, like, when the president was calling what he wanted and what his wife did, and you gotta watch the show to understand, but the first lady actually called Space Force with Steve Carell and wanted him to change the suits of all the Space Force people so it matched up to what she liked. It just seemed like something Ivana Trump would probably do. You don't think so?
Ivanka Trump is the daughter.
Ivanka, then what's the wife's name?
It begins with an M.
Melanie Trump?
I wonder why you say Melanie
Trump's
Trump.
My ex-wife. That's why I use that name. Yeah. Oh, pretty much everything. Did you like the show, what you saw of it?
No, yes, I did. I mean, I'll just be honest. No. I thought Space Force, I know the idea was out there, but I was like, wait.
What?
Are they actually going through this? And then I'm looking right now on actual job sites. There's a Space Force satellite engineer for the U.S. Force. There's a space operations specialist
they
for the International.
This.
Oh, my God.
It just happened to come parallel the same time.
Oh, my gosh.
So this is a real thing. There is a Space Force, and they're getting ready.
Woo! But what I will say this.
Hold on. What did Steve Carell say? Boots on the ground? The president said, boots on the ground by 2024.
Not Steve Carell, who went to Denison University. Great campus.
Ooh-ha.
But what I want to say, though, is it is a star cast. And with that, you would think it would be worthy of more than 39% from the critics from Rotten Tomatoes.
Show.
But this is why I think it should be 85%. There are some new folks like Diana Silvers, Jimmy O. Yang. I mean, and one who is a veteran, but he's often a C actor, Don Lake. They really glue the show together to keep it flowing, and it doesn't become boring. So, I enjoy Space Force.
I was so happy that...
And I'm very worried about the real-life Space Force with the leader we have right now.
I was so happy that Patrick Warburton, Buddy Putty, was on the TV show, played the general of the Marines.
All I have to say is Space Force is not the real life one because I don't have enough experience, but they're smart because they're catching all the audiences because they even have ads on TikTok. Well
great
played.
Show. So well I just have to say that I thought the show was great. Rotten Tomatoes, they've given things stuff bad.
That's true.
That was actually pretty good.
Yeah.
I forgot what it was, but
and if it's on Netflix,
there were a few shows.
Hey, what else are you going to do outside?
Yeah, there's nothing you can do about it.
Yeah, stay inside.
All right, so we're done with space. I'll let you know I nerded out a little bit because I was really proud of. Now I'm doing it. X Force, not space. No,
Space Force.
No, not
Space X.
Space X. Jesus, I'm all over the place.
Jesus.
All right, now it's time to talk about. Is this stupid or is it smart? Okay. So WFLA, and this is out of Florida, says Disney is going to begin reopening its Florida theme parks on July 11th. They closed because of the coronavirus. Okay. Is it smart or is it stupid? What do you think?
Well, on DisneyFoodBlog.com, there is a lot. It was just because there's other guests. There are a lot of concerns, even though it's limited. And I'm just going to back up what I tell friends, people I work with, and everyone. You got to follow the science. So I understand why they're doing because they're using
happened. The science is out the door today. Because right now we're talking about helicopters flying above us. There are protests everywhere. The science is out the door. The pandemic
that's my whole point. So if it's 23,000, they expect an increase prior to this in June. You know, you can have a lot of rules, but wait, where do they overseas did Disneyland open up?
That was in Beijing, Japan. Japan.
So I know that Disney Resorts in the U.S. we're following to see how's it going over there. The problem is that there is not enough science, and now with less funding to the WHO organization, how are we going to... So, it's the World Health Organization. Oh, yeah. funny. Got it. Anyway, I'm not planning on going for